and in the sound of his life, I would drift off to sleep. He came into the coffee shop where I worked. When I saw him, when I took his order, it was music, it was coffee. When I took his order, something came over me and I thought, this is my chance. He might help me escape if I could just find another life, then my days of running would be over. And I wouldn't even be the city anymore, the city which anyway only betrays me and leaves me exposed. Always alone, with what I fear most, the sound of my memories.
Church sometimes.
Are you some kind of psychopath? This is the question he asked me as we walked by Macy's. I had to admit I admired his forthrightness. I wasn't sure, however, what he meant by some kind of psychopath. Is there more than one kind? And if so, am I expected to know which category I fall under? I wanted to use this as an opportunity to tell him the truth. No, I am not a psychopath, but yes, I am disturbed. No, I am not cruel or dangerous, but yes, I am on the run. But of course, I said nothing like that. Of course, I said me. A psychopath, what are you talking about? Which is, of course, exactly how a psychopath would answer.
Into my right nostril, shoved upwards into the cavity of
whips. It hurts. It's pushing against the fleshy membrane, breaking through.
Fight to the death.
upon layers of flesh. Each layer is free, holding no memory. Some memories easier to touch, these put up front on display. Behind them others of shame and violation and pain. These left in obscure places, far back as possible. Yet their presence bleeds through. So that the viewer casually perusing the collection is disturbed. A chill runs through his body. For even as he gazes at the most ordinary of memories, he becomes aware of other images he is not supposed to see. In this way, the screens behind acquire a power greater than those in front. The room is saturated with the presence of things.
Off the face like water. Phone is dead.
The curtains descended on the day, bringing night. Darkness again, I'm in the dark again. The clock reads 1:35 a.m. My head is pounding itself raw. I have to take a pill, any pill. I run to the bathroom, pull open the medicine cabinet. And time leaves me. I step temporarily outside its domain. The metronome clicks, hums, sings an aria, and time obedient follows its lead. The bottle is in pieces on the floor, pills and broken glass beneath my feet. I step over them all, hard, letting the shards puncture the soles of my feet. Lodge themselves there, anything to keep me here in this world. Where is the clock? Clock! Oh, good is the clock. What does the clock do but spit out random numbers? Time is a lottery. 10:10 p.m.
Pushing it slightly off center, a
and in so doing, setting into motion a series of dislocations, like dominoes falling, shooting our Earth further and further towards the edge of the universe.
Is that your new color yet? It's this light left to breathe.
The world we see in a mirror, parallel to ours, precisely reversed. A world with its own rules, yet dependent on ours, as we on it, in order to see ourselves. Conforming to one, or one being split into many. window for his eyes like a spaceman. Like a spaceman. He would touch the hive, loaded with the fury all around his head. After the night sky opened, I remember spending hours, hours watching the hive, the buzzing growing louder and louder until it filled my brain, circling around my head, growing louder and louder. Because one day, after weeks of watching and listening, one day I walked towards him, not with the spaceman's uniform, but only my body, exposed and vulnerable as it is every day in the world. I walked up to the hive. And then, like an orb, I held it. And the pain that followed seemed to relieve me of all my questions. Until I woke up in a hospital bed, covered with welts and blood. And so, looking no longer human, I rose up like an enemy. I rose out of my bed, and I began to run. I must return to the hive in order to understand. But can I do it this time? Can I penetrate the swarms? This time I must not lose consciousness or else I wake up again in a hospital bed, running. It is pointless to remember. Remember, you will have spoken a heresy, a heresy. You will be an outcast. yet, if it is the truth, then I continue to deny in order to appear sane. Isn't that true of insanity?
Thank you.
Does it come again? I'm in my apartment. Is it a memory? No, I'm again in that converted farmhouse and the buildings. The city is gone. Something forms around me, taking shape. Something impossible. The sound. It's here. It's come for me again. I stand up in the air around me, exposed in the black sun. I grope for the window and the shade drops down on its own power. My chair rises up, bounces about to some electrical dance. The rest of the furniture joins in. The ashtray jumps off the coffee table and twirls like a top. The carpet rolls itself up and it springs back out again. Pots and pans in the kitchen clatter against one another, and the television explodes with a loud the sound of the electricity shorting out across the wires. All these sounds join hands until they are well around me, closing in. And the harmless sounds, they're once again solid. Once again, my visitor will not fall like a prisoner. No more apartment, no more city, no more people gone. All gone. Only the sound. A single sound. A taste. The sound. It's so absorbed in the sound that I take it along with me. We go away. place is supposed to be clean. This one smells like dead leaves rotting in the tropics. I breathe and the smell begins to permeate the very fibers of my brain and the living thing burning. What am I turning into? I look into those eyes. I see my face. into his face, seeing in his eyes a mirror reflecting myself. And all this time, he has been looking into my eyes, and he too has seen himself. Now I understand why we travel, why any of us ever feels the need to walk across a room towards another being whose heart beats and whose flesh smells of life. We are all visitors. We all travel. We all hope one day, looking into the eyes of another, to find part of an answer. We all perceive.
Thank you.
But now, I'm watching them too. And our familiarity, we've become distant equals. I'm thinking about maybe buying another farmhouse. Of course, I'd have to make money. I walk into the coffee shop, and my boss asks me where I've been.
Humans and our arrogance.
the doctor finds my explanation incomplete. He says, "Lying here, you talked in your sleep. Fantastic story." "It must be a dream," I reply. "Yes, probably. But I feel compelled to ask, you ever see faces above the subways?" "No, I do not. Have you ever been visited by beings from other worlds?" "I have not." "You've never been afraid to return to a farmhouse?" "No." "You never touched a beehive?" "No." "Has your apartment building ever disappeared before your eyes?" "It has not." "Do you understand the mechanics of the fourth and fifth dimensions?" "I do not." "Do you even have any idea what they are?" "I do not." "Have you ever studied Zen or any of the Eastern disciplines?" "I have not." "Is there imprinted in your person a plan of the cosmos?" "There is none." "Does the presence of a silver globe mean anything to you?" "It does not." "Has your hand ever drawn in its spare moments machines beyond your comprehension?" "It has not." "Have you ever seen any such machines?" "I have not." "Do you remember a room smelling of rotting leaves?" "I do not." "Do hives such as those of bees and other insects play a part in your memories?" "They do not." "Did anyone ever ask you to remember?" "No one has asked that." "Have you ever looked into the eyes of another and there found answers?" "No." "Have you ever seen yourself in the face of another?" "No." "You never crawled in any small globe?" "No." "You never followed a line of faces?" "No." "You never shot out across space?" "No." "You've never been told to forget?" "Nope." "You have nothing to forget?" "No." "You're forgetting nothing?" "That is correct." "The doctor tells me I may return to the world. I will no longer tell stories which cannot be verified. I will wear clothes which are not soiled with myself. I will wear makeup and dress in conservative colors.